All. In this lecture, we are going to see how we are finding inverse. So finding inverse will be involved in many of the cryptographic systems and cryptographic problems. Let us see how to find. For finding inverse, we have a standard table. So the standard table is Q, A, the standard table has 7 columns and the column headers are Q, A1, A2, A3, B1, B2 and B3, right? And we are having formula for evaluating each and every column. So Q will be A3 dash. Dash in the sense you have to take the value from the previous row. So A3 dash divided by B3 dash. And A1, A2, A3 will be having B1 dash, B2 dash and B3 dash respectively. Then B1 will be A1 dash minus QB1 dash. Likewise, it goes for B2 and B3. So let us see an example. Before that, the first row is a standard row. Q will not be having any value. A1 and A2 will be having 1 and 0. B1, B2 will be having 0 and 1. So 1, 0, 0, 1 is a constant standard value. The n value should be placed in A3. So this is the first step. Next step, we are trying to find the value for second row. For second row, Q is A3 dash minus B3 dash. So previous rows, A3 value is 288. A3 dash divided by B3 dash, previous 88 and B3 value is 13. 288 divided by 13, you will be getting 22. Then you have to write the value for A1, A2 and A3. You have to copy it from the previous rows B1, B2 and B3. So 0, 1, 13, I am copying it here, 0, 1, 13. Next, you have to find the value of B1. So B1 is equal to A1 dash minus Q into B1 dash. So 1 minus 22 into 0, that is 1. So I have written 1. Then B2. So old A2 value minus Q into old B2 value. So 0 minus 22 into 1, that is minus 22. So it is minus 22. Then B3 value, A3 value minus Q into old B3. So that is 288 minus 22 into 13. That is 288 minus 286, that is 2. So the second step is over. The third step. So how long should I do this? Till in the B3 value I am getting 1, I have to repeat the steps. Once if I am getting 1, the value of B2 will be my answer. So I didn't get 1, so I am proceeding for, to another one iteration. So Q value is A3 dash divided by B3 dash, 13 divided by 2, 6. Always remember you have to use only the quotient part. If you are performing modulo, it is remainder. If you are performing division, it is only quotient. Never ever use a decimal part or a fractional part, anything like that. Don't do round off. Only the quotient must be written here. So 6 and A1, A2, A3 values are previous B1, B2, B3. So it is 1 minus 22 and 2. Here 1 minus 22 and 2. Then B1 value is equal to previous A1 minus Q into previous B1. So 0 minus 6, minus 1 into 6, that is minus 6. Then B2 is 1 minus 6 into minus 22. So 1 minus 6 into minus 22 is 1 minus minus 132, that is 1 plus 132, that is 133. I have written 133 here. Then B3 value is previous A3 value minus Q into previous B3 value. That is 13 minus 6 into 2. That is 13 minus 12, 1. So we are getting 1. If we are getting 1, we can stop the iteration and we can write the answer as B2's value. So the value of B2 is 133 and my answer is 133. So 13 inverse mod 288 is 133. Suppose if I am getting a negative number, I have to again apply modulus. For how to find a modulus for negative number, we saw in the last lecture series itself. Thank you.